We have with us a person who has done something few congressmen have ever done. She read every line in the Affordable Care Act, Obamacare, and she's an expert, and she's going to tell us about what it's going to do to you. Okay?
How long did that take?
I don't know. I mean, it's like a life calling, I suppose, but she is an expert, and I think your eyes will be opened. Well, you ready to have your eyes open?
Yes, we need to on Obamacare.
Okay. Well, going internationally, what would happen if the nation of Iran gets a nuclear bomb? Well, for Israel, that's not just a hypothetical. It's a matter of life and death.
Today, international powers are resuming their talks with Iran over its nuclear program, and Israel warns that such a weapon could be a threat to the United States as well. Chris Mitchell has that story from Jerusalem.
Israel got a boost this week during a three-day visit by French President François Hollande. France stopped the last round of talks in Geneva when it refused Iran's terms. In a speech to Israel's parliament, Hollande said he would hold the line on sanctions.
It is now for Iran to respond, not just with words, but with concrete measures that are verifiable. And I affirm here that sanctions will be maintained until Iran has definitely removed its nuclear weapons program.
Hollande's speech was good news for Israeli leaders who feel an interim agreement would let Iran off the sanctions hook.
This is one of our concerns, that since this interim agreement is so good for Iran and so convenient for the Iranians, they are giving entirely nothing and getting a lot of reductions on the sanctions and legitimation as a threshold nuclear country.
This is the most frightening nightmare of all that we're dealing with in foreign policy.
U.S. Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann was in Israel this month and told CBN News it's the wrong time to go easy on Iran.
Just when economic sanctions are really working, we've got Iran exactly where they're about to have their back broken. They're down on their knees, and just when they're down on their knees, the Obama administration wants to pull all the pressure back, and they want to give Iran the space they need, in addition to the luxury of time, to finish their project of developing a nuclear weapon.
Bachmann believes Iran's nuclear program and its supreme leader, Khamenei, threaten both Israel and the West.
Khamenei will not only use a nuclear weapon against Israel, they will use it against any other Western civilization. They will use it against Europe. They will use a nuclear weapon against the United States of America. Don't think for a moment that they won't. They will. They seek the elimination of the United States just as surely as they seek the elimination of the Jewish state of Israel.
But Israel is not the only concerned country in the region. The Gulf states just across the Persian Gulf, and especially Saudi Arabia, see Iran as Israel does.
I think the evidence is undeniable that the Israeli and Saudi positions vis-a-vis Iran and the need to prevent a nuclear Iran and the deep concerns regarding the current direction of events in Geneva and in the negotiations, you know, the evidence of that is unmistakable. Israel and Saudi Arabia are on the same page vis-a-vis Iran.
In the meantime, Israel is campaigning against any agreement that would allow Iran to get a nuclear bomb. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu will be in Moscow this week to lobby Russian President Vladimir Putin. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Excellent, Chris. I appreciate the word from Michelle Bachmann, too. That's very cogent, and I believe the Congress gets it. The president, I don't know what it is going on in his mind, but to think that France is now more strong in foreign policy than America is just simply amazing. But they've taken the lead, and we're now, quote, leading from behind, way behind. Well, Iran is holding an American pastor in a brutal prison for charges relating to his Christian faith. John Jessup has an update on that story from Washington. Here's John.
Pat, that's right. Pastor Saeed Abedini was allowed a family visit for the first time since his transfer to Rajashahr prison. The American Center for Law and Justice says this is a positive sign and that international pressure is working to keep Pastor Saeed alive. Since his sudden transfer to this facility, far worse than the last prison, Pastor Saeed has been denied his medicine. Last week, the U.S. Senate unanimously passed a bipartisan resolution calling for his release. A similar measure is pending in the House. You can find out more about what's being done to help Pastor Saeed Abedini by going to our website at cbnnews.com. The Census Bureau and a congressional subcommittee are investigating a report about fake numbers in the unemployment report ahead of last year's election. The Census Department puts together the numbers for the monthly report, and an employee in that department told a writer for the New York Post that he'd been told to make up information for the report by his superiors. That could have been done to make the jobless numbers look better than they really were. Some people, including former GE CEO Jack Welch, did raise questions when the employment rate fell sharply last year. The Census Department says it doesn't believe there was any widespread manipulation. Pat, it may be too soon to tell, but do you think if the numbers weren't manipulated, that could have impacted last year's election results?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the unemployment rate was about 8.2%, and they said, well, it's really 7.7%, or so we got it under 8%. And they did it, if this whistleblower is correct, by faking the numbers. That is horrible, because so many businesses in America gear their activities on the basis of honest numbers coming out of the Commerce Department and various other departments of government. This, is there any other lie that they can be telling in the administration? You just ask yourself, when is this lying going to stop, and how soon are the American people going to wake up? They're being conned, John.
Pat, the new law regulating abortion clinics in Texas will stand for now after the Supreme Court said it would not get involved in the case. About a third of the state's clinics have closed under the law since October, but Planned Parenthood is still fighting, saying the legal battle isn't over yet. Meanwhile, voters in Albuquerque rejected a ballot measure that would have banned abortions after 20 weeks, except to save the mother's life.
For women to have control over their own bodies.
But supporters of banning late-term abortions say the fight is far from over.
While we are disappointed, we will come back stronger. We will keep moving forward. We will never back down. We will never give up.
Paid professional hackers and cybersecurity experts warn that personal information on the Obamacare website isn't safe. A panel of experts told members of Congress at a hearing the website is susceptible to hackers and criminals, and they could gain access to Americans' sensitive private information like Social Security numbers, birthdays, and income. One expert warned hackers could even access, enable, and monitor a computer's webcam and microphone and steal passwords. Democrats say it isn't the only website with vulnerabilities, but Texas Republican Lamar Smith says given the massive amount of personal data collected by the website, it's time to take Obamacare off of life support. And Pat, another concern that was raised during that hearing is that that website is connected to other federal agencies like the IRS and the Department of Homeland Security.
Don, it's appalling. It's simply appalling that this amount of information, who would want, you know, if a hacker can get your Social Security, can get your bank number, can get other information about your family, he or she, it would be like having a key to the vault. They can then raid everything you've got and beggar you, take all your money. But if they get your bank account or your brokerage account and you get your Social Security number and a few other pieces of information, a clever crook can take it all. And to make this open, and the cyber hackers say it's an easy thing to break into the Obamacare website, this thing ought to be given a death. It should not be given an honorable burial. It should be given a dishonorable burial, interned, and start all over again. There was a proposal today which has a great deal of merit. If we're going to subsidize the health care of those who are uninsured, let's let the private sector do it, and let's take some federal money, if that's what they want to do, and spend it on doing this. But let's not have a plan which penalizes healthy people to make them pay the costs of unhealthy people. It's a backdoor attempt at socialism, and it's driving people crazy. But for the Republicans, it is a gift that keeps on giving. And it means the control of the Senate, it means control of the House continuing, and it undoubtedly means control of the White House. If the Republicans won't screw it up, they've been given a gift, and they should take advantage of it.
Well, at some point, don't the Republicans have to come up with something better? And
well, just what I just said would do it. I mean, you know, a private plan to say, okay, you've got poor people, you've got poor people who are not insured, they're facing desperation with their health care. We will get a situation. One thing is enormously high deductibles and, you know, limited coverage. But for example, to take a man who is 60 years old and make him pay insurance for maternal health care, I mean, it's just nonsense.
It's ridiculous.
And then to say, well, your plan is inadequate according to our guidelines. Inadequate for whom?
Yeah. The American people didn't sign up for socialism.
No, they didn't, and they were lied to. And I mean, but if, according to a CBS poll that I read today, Obama's ratings are now diminishing more. He's sliding. Hmm. And I don't think he can recover. I think this thing is so bad. And the trouble is, the more he discusses it, the worse it gets.
Hmm. New legislation allowing gay marriage in Illinois could pose a threat to some businesses. While the legislation says religious institutions, clergy, and some private clubs don't have to allow or officiate gay weddings, it isn't as clear for businesses whose owners may not want to participate because it violates their own religious beliefs. That could result in more court battles, as other states have seen. Studies of children around the world show kids today are far less fit than their parents were. An analysis of those studies by the American Heart Association shows kids don't run as fast or as far as their parents did when they were young. Heart-related fitness also has declined 5% per decade since 1975. Health experts recommend children 6 and older get 60 minutes of moderately vigorous activity throughout each day. Well, you can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.